I've done a video recently about cleanliness, and that's my mantra, and clean, clean, clean. And if you've seen enough of my videos, you know that that's really my motto. But it's okay to tell people that cleanliness is important. It's another thing to show them why it's important. I have here currently an EXFO TDR, but we're using it as a microscope, and we're using the OTR as the screen and the software. And I have a microscope, and you can see this is a wired one. EXFO does offer a Bluetooth version, wireless. The Avi has microscopes, Fluke, and Ritsu. We all have video microscopes out here. Just happen to have the EXFO unit here. And I want to talk about end face analysis and dirt and contamination really in the same video. So for years, for decades, end face analysis was always held to the person viewing the connector. So what might be a blemish or a scratch to some people might be not there to the others, and vice versa. So, you know, a few years ago, a standard was set on end face analysis. It's the IEC standard, IEC 61300-3-35. Not that you need to know that number, but that is what it is. And basically, the IEC standard defines four areas of a connector, basically zones A, B, C, and D. Zone A being the core, B is the cladding area, C is the epoxy and the epoxy ring, and D would be what we call the contact zone. That would be your ferrule. Every one of these zones has a different pass fail threshold for there's really two criteria. There's I believe contamination, and I believe scratches and pits. I will show you in this video, we'll present on the slide from my manual, from my book. You'll see that there's a multi-mode and a single mode standard. The multi-mode standard is a little less stringent than the single mode, but it shows, and you'll notice when you look at that chart, you'll notice that the core area, zone A, is really the most important. That's our light gathering area. And that really, when it says scratches and defects, I believe for both multi and single mode, zero. So it's pretty stringent. As we move out into the ferrule, you know, the cladding and then the ferrule itself, we get a little more leeway with some defects. You know, our goal is to be defect free. The new microscope probes that we have, with a push of a button, or the EXFO has actually an auto analysis and auto capture feature where it will actually, once you plug it in, it will actually do the IEC test for you automatically without initiating it. I've turned that off on this unit, but if you turn it on, it just does it for you automatically. Really critical that we follow these standards. My other reason for this video, again, is to show you contamination and dirt. So I also have here, just as a quick note, this is a handheld microscope. You know, I think every technician, I always do the analogy of ever go to a doctor and not see him with a stethoscope. I would never go to a doctor without a stethoscope or a blood pressure cuff. That's about as important as a microscope is to a fiber technician. You know, now, can everybody afford to do a $2,000 to $3,000 microscope for their technicians? No. But when we look at a handheld scope, which does the same thing, excluding the test, we can't do the IEC test with a handheld scope. But for field work, you know, something that's less than $100 with interchangeable back ends so we can do the different connector styles, it's essential. I'm not saying everyone should have a video microscope, but they are also handy too, especially for certification and end face testing. So that's becoming a requirement. So I want to move over to the unit now. These microscopes, you can get different tips for them. Right now we have a 2.5 millimeter tip for the ST we're going to show you, but you can get the female versions, the 1.25 versions for your LCs. You can get the multi ones that I've done a video on for the MPO connections, and there's 100 different ones for some of the different specialty connectors out there. Again, we're just using the standard 2.5 mil. So I've got my EXFO unit set to auto center and auto focus, which is a nice feature. The unit itself does have a manual focus, but I really enjoy the centering and the focusing, the automatic stuff. It's very intuitive. So you'll see I'm gonna connect this ST connector in here. I haven't done anything to it. And if we look here, It auto-focused and auto-centered. And so what do we see? We can see our fiber, and we can see it's very contaminated. So we're gonna get some attenuation from this for sure, possible damage to the connector that if we plug this into. Again, sight unseen, you know, again, my mantra, clean, clean, clean before you do anything. So I'm just gonna try one of the cleaning devices I have here. My one click cleaner. I'm just gonna give it one click like advertised. And we're gonna put her back in and see what we get here. And lo and behold, a very clean connection. This is what we're looking for. All right, I have another connector here. This would be another ST. This is actually from the other side of the cord I cut. You might wonder why I cut it. Well, because this connector was bad. I've set to this unit, I've set the auto capture and the auto analysis on here now. So when I plug this in, you're gonna see the unit focus, center, capture the image, and then test it to that IEC standard. You'll see green layers or green rings for the different layers. One of the layers we can't control that really has no standard is that epoxy ring. We can't control epoxy. It's not doing anything for our light. So they kind of, that's a known ring, but really there's no limits set on that unit or that area. I'm gonna plug it in. If you'll notice, I just touched the end here to show you how quickly I can contaminate this. And as we plug, one of the things I want you to notice also as it's going through its process, you'll see a blue flashing light on the top here. I can tell right away if this pass or fails the IEC test just by the color that it is once it's finished with the test. Obviously, we see a nice green light. We knew that this was a pass. This helps automate us, but you know, look what we got here, a red. I don't even really have to look at this to know it's probably contaminated and very dirty. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna reset this. I'll take the connector out and I'm gonna go back to my live video and I'm gonna clean off that contamination. But you're still gonna see those scars that I mentioned will still be there. And I'm gonna be pretty assured that this will also fail. So I can hear the unit focusing and my blue light is flashing again here. It should be going through its steps. One of the issues we have, you know, cleanliness is a great, it's not, I'm not happy about it, but it's something that we can fix or control. Damage, that's another story. Chip shatters and breaks. The connector is garbage at this point. We have to cut it. And as we can see here, the red light, it didn't pass the IEC standard and I couldn't certify this. And I know, again, by the red highlights that it leaves, what the problems were. Again, this is mating damage, but I just wanted you to see how effective a microscope is, and really more importantly, how effective our cleaning materials are when we use it with fiber. Really important. I know I stress it all the time, but this is really great proof of why cleanliness has to be our first and last thought. So thank you for watching the video, and I hope that this encourages you to watch others. Thanks again.
Subscribe to our channel for new videos.